I'm from 2 years from the Beast Corporation, which is on site. I had 11% beer, which was dedicated to one pumpkin, and dedicated to another pumpkin who passed away. It's cool that they looked like folk, but I thought it was a bit forgettable. The 11% was insane, almost really malty and really sweet. A lot for drinking, but it's nice that they take beer to their local folk. It's pork hole, is there? Or those? So I just left the Oberlin at the Northern Monk Patrons project, which has a little slight spice to it, 8.7%. The Salter Winter Spice, which is all butter, no spice. Which I probably won't have ever again. This just wasn't that good. But yeah, probably shouldn't have 2 incense beers, like 11% beer from Beast Walk and makes it from normal. But so that's fun. But yeah, on the blue. Good section of beers on. This is where I would have tried more than the new ones. But there you go, try something new. But next spot call is Triangle. Triangle, Burntville. Green Path is a Citra and Mosaic IPA 6%. Pale golden. Slight bit of honeycomb.
2009.
Body's nice. Slight.
Oh, is that Tom Fisher?
Roll beer. From Burntville. West Coast. Leaning IPA with a tropical fruit pile of aroma. From the layering of Citra, Mosaic, and the hops. A stripped back malt profile, low bitterness and dry finish, keep everything lean and drinkable eye. We're in at 6% from Badley, Suffolk. Here with the Triangle. Sugar. Eastie Boys Majestic 2015. 7.5%. This is the bottle
thing.
A beetroot. Confused beer.
It's surprising, isn't it? Actually, yeah. To be honest, I've never really got into Yeasty Boys. I've tried a few of their things,
a little bit
like the Big Mouth. I just don't get it. No.
It reminds me of Bloody Mary, or what?
Right.
Which is just fruits of tomato.
Yeah. There's a few like that. I was thinking about Wild Beer actually the other day. You know, they get so much respect there, but do they actually get the respect in the brewing community?
Brewery and their Taru Season Rule. And where is it in? 8.5% 2015. Which is like the Easter Boys 2015.
It's quite breathy. Fresh breath.
Yeah.
Really kind of bright. It's like your washing powder's a bit more nicer than urinal cake. And I'm sure not everybody
washing powder.
It's like wheat ale to an extent.
It is.
Light, it's nice. Light, taste of the grass. A little bit of Earl Grey. I love this beer. Apple is well done. But this is the Brewer Taru 2015. This is the Nook. This is the Rhubarb Indie Pale Ale, 5.2%. The Rhubarb Festival is coming up in Wakefield in February. Here you get chance.
How are you? Nothing bad.
Slight perfumey on the. It reminds me of the purple sweets that I used to have as a child.
You were concerned about your
not bad beer. Easy drinkable. Get a little bit of lavender on the aftertaste. Purchase this at the Kill and Fan Shop. Here I am. Right on the bottle shelf. So this is the Nook India Pale Ale, 5.2%, NIPA, brewery out of Old Firth here in Yorkshire.
That's a ripper,
right? Oh, I do. Well, man.
Easy, nice, biscuity beer, just easy drinkable. Here at the Triangle in Shiplet, purchased this at the Keel & Pound Shop in Dedham. Bourbon Barrel Breakfast Stout. The Pale Nook Stout with coffee aged in bourbon barrels. Kuma Coffee.
Order on the route.
From Seattle. Vintage 2016. 10.4%.
Have you got Wi-Fi?
So what? I don't know if Steve's been in.
Slight bit of herbal.
Steve's from Crooked Brewery. Just started. Where are you based?
A little bit of burnt wood.
No, yeah, York and there.
A little bit of red apple.
Brilliant. So he's brought some beers down apple. Just to try. And like we can do it with Steve here or without.
What does it look like?
He's just asked.
Alcohol's well, he didn't.
Feedback on what we're thinking. Probably nice. Beer's
so, Crooked from Tadcaster, this is the Brewed from the Wood.
My daily commute, that's where we pass. Slow moving, stopping services.
Yes.
Not much on the aroma, but sometimes when you drink, you open the aromas up.
Yeah, I'm just wondering
if body is medium. There's a slight aftertaste that's quite nice, quite addictive.
No, it's
I can maybe see why it's green
when
next to
me.
I
yeah, there's definitely green apple.
I got it on the nose.
It's more like crystal malt.
You might taste that, but as an offer, it's not
good.
It's a Wambas. Not bad beer. New brewer in Tadcaster, here in Yorkshire. Here at the bottle shirt. Cigar City, the vanilla hazelnut Marshall Zukovs. I'm sure it's like a James Bond villain. This is the Imperial Stout, this is vanilla and hazelnut added. Cigar City. I've had a few Cigar Cities for a while. Here at the Triangle Bottle Shirt.
I'm not totally successful.
Get a little bit of burnt cigar. Charred wood. Body is smooth. You get a little bit of dark chocolate in the aftertaste. The vanilla is very salt. The hazelnut non-existent. This Russian Imperial Stout is dedicated to Georgi Zhukov, arguably one of the finest generals of World War II. Huge in body with strong flavors of espresso. It just gets sweet bit of chocolate and chocolate and molasses. You get the molasses definitely. The unique iteration of Zhukov's adds roasted hazelnuts and vanilla and impact even more complexity and depth of flavor. Jet black stout in the mortal words of Marshall Zhukov himself. Yeah, not reading Russian. She's not the beer. Not sure the beat, but it's really nice beer. Probably one of the best beers I've had before this year, so there's not been that many. Anyway, I've got a share in Shipley. So this is Abstract 14 from BrewDog. It was brewed in 2013, and it's 10.2%. Comes with this fancy green bottle. It is 2018. Colour is...
It's not fair that you're
Red and brown.
It
kind of smells like a red wine.
Massive change in style.
No, no, no. It's not that much.
You get a little bit of burnt topping.
Flew us up there. All three of us who revived on that particular thing were. It was me, Musico.
Oh, it's smooth. Right. A little bit of taste of white chocolate in the palate. Quite nice. A little bit of light coffee, a little soft caramel. That's a lovely beer. Here at the Triangle, probably the best beer I've had this session so far. So this is the Founders Lizard or Course. Imperial Stout will be blueberries, chocolate and vanilla aged in bourbon barrels. 10.5%. A slight bit of marmalade, a little bit of burnt toast, a slight bit of those lavender sweets, a little bit of root beer, Dr. Pepper, a slight bit of herbal wood.
I'm thinking in my head,
palate is medium, a little bit of the axe sweets, a little bit of ashkas. Palate's quite nice and it's drinkable. 10.5%. Nibbling's a bit offset, but usual warnings. Lovely beer. From Founders. Here at the Shibuya. Bullshit.
I'm trying to read the label.
So this is a 5-year-old Westville Rayleigh 12. Last time I had this was a share in Reading. This reminds me of Christmas. I don't know why. Quite a bit of fern. A little bit of damp wood. Black cherry.
How old were the Westphalians that you were giving away?
Smooth. The body's a little bit medium.
Was it last year? Was it the year?
The alcohol content is.
I think it might have been the year before, actually.
10.2%. Well, it didn't.
I've not tried it yet.
5 years. Love a beer. Here at Bosch in Triangle. This is the Sierra Nevada 30th anniversary, the Sierra. 9.2% is a Grand Cru. We were talking about making money in any town. You don't have any money in any
town. The thing is, there's nothing I can pick out.
Really? Such a demoration?
There's a few times I could drink a beer and go.
All brown flakes? Ooh, smoothness in the body. Nice medium body. Almost like a milky Belgian chocolate. That's nice. Yeah. 9.2%. Well hidden. Here at the Triangle Bullshit. This is the product of the Belgium, the barrel-aged Clube de Jacobs. The Rouge, this is 5.5%. It's a Flemish sour ale. Beer de Fadoul. Here at the Bullshit.
I got in at half 10 and I think we were until about half
run. As the elements of a Zinfandel.
Savage Square, I was going to say, he's like, oh, was that
one? Slightly bit of green apple.
What's his
name?
Oxley.
Yeah,
Oxley.
Oh,
yesterday,
he's like,
the first thing he said was, yeah, he's an
heavy
drinker, isn't he?
It's lovely,
tastes
it?
On the back. Yeah, so, I don't know.
It kind of tastes like just before you have a bite of
jerky. Oh yeah, with BrewDog, yeah.
It's jerky. We're looking for brands that they can quite nice. A little bit of charred meat. This at the bottle share in chocolate. Try it. The Omnipolo Tidans Breakfast IPA. It's a collaboration with Omnipolo and Tidans. It's 7.2%.
This is the word. It's
their milkshake.
The other way to drink this is to sip it, give it 2 seconds.
It's £15 a can.
Just keep going.
Colour is...
Like, it's
cranberry juice,
I don't
a little
know
bit of raspberry.
Can even be. Tasting that flavour, I can't. I don't even know what.
No,
what that
a slight
is.
Bit of banana peel.
It's like a yeast has gone crazy and
taken
over.
A little bit of frozen yogurt.
What's
that
flavour? What's the adjective? Lactose.
Raspberry. Blueberries.
If
what
I could
do
you drink
that,
Catherine?
Get...
No.
That is a bit flaccid.
Finish is...
7.2%.
The finish is
horrible. The finish is what's killing me.
Yeah, I think if you did a mouthful every 2 seconds,
you'd have a bit
you'd kind of keep getting past that finish. And then just, you have to just kind of deal with it at the end. But.
It's kind of...
It's a bit
like... Flying,
you know when you have like really, really mature cheddar, you've got like almost like a white film. That kind of yeastiness you get from the cheese when you eat
a frozen yogurt.
What the fuck is that?
No longer frozen.
Is it kind of like a weird combination of reaction?
Yeah, some
like
that,
yeah, no, right, lactose.
Rudolph, Omnipolo. Freaking out. Fudge caramel, creamy milk chocolate. You still, you do get a bit of the barrel aged there. That's so good. It smells too good for a beer.
Yes.
I'm like, no. You smelled it.
It's bitter as hell.
Jesus.
It's a health drink that has for his stomach.
Slightly creamy. A little bit of taste of light.
Yeah,
so I have a little bit. Lovely taste. Here at the bottle shirt in
Chipotle. That's going to be...
So, this is a patisserie from...
Are you bringing this? Yeah.
Time and Tide.
Optimism.
A patisserie is... Remember, it's a saison from France.
Yeah,
it's supposed to be a town saison.
I've never heard of them, to be honest.
Slight bit of red apple.
Kent. My mate was in...
This has been aged in white burgundy barrels.
I'm
going
to get off. Actually, to get back to come back.
Easy, nice, drinking beer.
Sober,
and it's been a past beer with Brett. Brett. It's been burning barrels.
Yeah.
5.4%.
See you about 10.
It's
triangle.
So, this is the abstract wealth from Brewdog. And this is bottled on 12th. This is 9159. This is 11.7%. So a beer that's almost 6 years old. It's like I'm pouring liquid something in my mouth, like liquid leather. I'm not enjoying this at all. 11%. You don't taste alcohol, you don't even taste beer. Just like I'm pouring leather in my mouth.
There's a lot of
yeah. Oh, I really liked it.
Yeah, we all enjoyed it.
No, it's
this is the remuneration of
Sunset.
This is this.
At
the bottle share in the triangle in Shipper. This is the Macropolis. This is the.
If that makes sense, it's not a.
Wheat sour, spontaneous, brewed with lemon zest, aged in bone barrels at 10.7%.
Another one.
if that makes sense. Like, I wouldn't drink it and go, oh,
I'm like today. Yeah, it's well kind of
fantastic. White wine.
I used to always, like, early days, first time I ever had Schlenker. I bought it by mistake, expecting something else.
Yeah.
And I suppose an ale is normally an ale made with herbs. Yeah.
Try this. Drink it.
So I'm guessing this is a beer made with herbs and lemon zest.
Because it had a similar label to this really nice lager I bought.
I don't get any lemon zest.
This is bad. Beer is. I mean, nice lagers and wheat beer.
Yeah. He's drinking. It's almost the form of a Ibby the Bradford. But this is nice. But this tastes like a white wine.
I think Bigfoot as well, because I was like, oh, I'm seeing
it. You got the triangle in Chipotle for the bullshit.
2.5 years is the optimum.
This is the 2009 edition of Orval.
I just do not like it.
It is 2018.
So it's like a 9. In Amsterdam, we had one that was about 1 month fresh, and I always did drink it. I was like,
It was exactly 4 weeks old. Yeah. We're out on my birthday, the 16th of March. It was bottled on the 14th.
A bit of white grape.
Loads of grape. Loads of
hops. The alcohol content is 6.2%. But
I haven't done this thing yet.
9 years old. Orval. Here at the bullshit in Triangle, Irish Club.
Doing some of the better stuff around.
Cookie Steve and then Nightmare on Brett. This is the That's Our Ale. It's in Leopold Brothers Whiskey Barrels.
Is intentional or not?
This is a Dark Sour at 96666%.
96666.
Is in Whiskey Barrels.
Ridiculous
breweries. 6.6 Because I've really measured that.
There's a key wine tower to do it with as well, don't they?
No, that's not 6.6.
No, but it's pie in it, the pie thing.
Oh, yeah, which is that's right. 3.14. Something
we're looking for another teacher, another time, another direction.
Yeah, it's just our teachers in that shit that long.
You have to do a bit of cover once in a while.
You when you bite into a nice apple and cherry pie.
I do cover.
You get that firm crust.
We're doing some geometric arms or something like that.
Lovely beer. All the way from Denver, Colorado. Here's to Yorkshire, UK. This is the Time and Tide, the Binary, the blend it says on barrel aged white burgundy, 5.7%. It's blend it says on aged in white burgundy barrels. Smells like baby vomit. A little bit of egg custard. Probably not the best beer to end a day, but this is the bottle share for the Triangle. So this is the Kumbaka and the Icebox, which means an iced beer on dark. This is weighs in at 9.2%. It's passed its date by 5 years. Yeah. Slight bit of dark coal, a little bit of black cola, a little bit of almost like smoked element to it. Not like beer, but the fact that it's held up all these years.
Okay.
Here's a little share. Right. Stillwater Super Hop and Neo Tropic Indie Pale Ale 6%.
Nobody's doing that. I talked to Gracky.
Other than Canva, I still want to ask Bradford, Connecticut.
Nice thing, so
just shoot by 12%.
No one's insisted on a
couple of things. Look York. And Cask is Sweden.
And if you're a new brewery,
you're demanding that kind of shit.
So, each Cladwell are now putting on their cans, expected or recommended, like storage conditions.
A little bit of caramel, slight biscuits.
Someone actually asked them and said, this is all great that you've won your beer
Cold and that shit. A little bit of honeycomb. Nice beer.
Quite lucky in that all that is involved within a certain month.
Light on the palate, but...
This is our fridge.
So, the last beer of the Bolshe is an homebrew. Provided by people from the Bolshe. This is the Hear Mint. On the first day of Xmas, my true love gave to me a mint. A mint chocolate stout. Beautiful artwork.
No, it is really nice.
This takes into the terms of Christmas and supply. But this is a 10.4% home brew. All grain with extracts in inclusive.
And some chocolate
milk. I remember
mint is very profound on the aroma.
Mine with the when he was in front of Roy Gals.
One
thing when he was doing even my Jesus,
what he found
best
way to get chocolate
flavour into
stout,
which
is cocoa powder.
You can get a little bit of the licorice on the back. The milk can be a little off putting in fairness, but you have to kind of account for all the processed beer.
Sorry.
So, initially the mint is not
good.
Sure, I'm kind of being professional.
You are being very professional. It's not like you.
Anyway. Initially, when you do have an over sense of one thing, you have to... going back in, just make sure you over appreciate. This reminds me of Viscounts a little bit. Chocolate, mint, and everything, all that good as from your childhood. And at 10%, it's well hidden. And compared to the beers we've had today, from homebrew to experimental and stuff like that. This is probably one of the airlines. Oh, the beers we've had today. We've had Ballet, we've had Spread and all stuff like that. But yeah, it's nice that this kind of experience happens at a ball share. You should bring what you want to bring. Share what you want to share. Here at the Triangle.